This video follows on from the video which gave an overview of how to set up a TotalStation using the Setup app. That is, how to position and orientate the TotalStation. This video will describe how to set up a TotalStation using the known backsight method. The known backsight method can be used in the following case. If the point over which you will position the TotalStation is known, there is only one backsight and the point over where the backsight is located is known. Normally, this will be a prism mounted on a tripod, but it could also be a reflective tape mounted on a wall, or even simply a mark on a wall. You don't need to be able to measure a distance to the backsight, that is optional, but you do need to be able to see the backsight. So let's run through the method. As always, move the job we want to use to the centre of the carousel. This means the setup information, for example the instrument height, the target point used and so on, will be stored to this job. Now tap on the Setup app. Choose the known backsight method and press OK. And we access the Choose Setup Point panel. Here we can choose from where the setup point shall be selected. The options are from a job, enter new point, GS Smart Station and last used. If you choose from job, then any point from any job can be selected. This is useful since it means if your control points are stored in a different job, you can select a point from that job. Enter new point is obvious. In the next panel, it would be possible to enter the point ID and coordinates of a new point. The GS Smart Station option is really cool. This allows the location of the TotalStation to be measured using a GS sensor sitting on top of the TotalStation. And last use setup can be useful if you have returned to exactly the same location as the day before, for example. We will choose to enter a new point, press OK, enter the point ID, and enter the known coordinates. And now we access the set orientation panel where we need to measure to the known backsight. Firstly, we need to choose the backsight point. This is the ID of the point to which we will aim the instrument and measure. This can be selected from the list of points, including searching for the point or graphically within the 3D viewer. Enter the target height. The direction and distance between the TotalStation and target is computed. It is optional if you want to measure a distance to the target or not. If you do measure to the target, then you will see the measured distance and the difference to the computed distance. This is a useful check since it may help to check you are aiming to the correct target and or have entered the correct instrument and target heights. On the backsight page tab, the backsight point can be given a point code if needed. On the setup page tab, the setup point can be given a point code if needed. The current PPM is shown as a reminder as to what PPM or scale factor is being used. If you are using an imaging TotalStation, the camera page tab can be used to aim the instrument to the backsight point. In the plot page tab, it is possible to see a 3D view of the setup. This can be useful to visually check you have set up on the correct point and aiming to the correct backsight. Once you are happy that all information is entered and the instrument is correctly aimed at the backsight, then press Set. This will store all setup information to the job. If you are using an imaging TotalStation, you will be asked if you want to capture a panoramic image. And then you will return to the home screen. The instrument is set up and you can get to work. The settings panel of the Setup app can be accessed using FN and then settings from within the app. Here you can find some useful settings. In this video, I only describe those which are relevant for the known backsight method. For example, if you want to measure to the target point in two faces, then tick this checkbox. If you do have a prism on the target and don't want it to be found when using a power search, then tick this checkbox. Another video explains more about this setting. In the known backsight page tab, you can enter limits in position and height. If during the measurement of the backsight the limits are exceeded, a message box is shown before the setup is stored. When using the Setup app on the CS Field Controller, the F4 GS key is extremely useful if you're using a smart pole. That is, you are using a GS sensor mounted on the prism on top of the pole. This key then allows a point to be measured with the GS sensor, which can then immediately be used to orientate the total station. This is really useful if there are no known backsites in the area. You can establish a new backsite using the GS sensor where it is most useful. So in summary, the known backsite method is a simple method to use when you know the point over which you will position the total station and you have a backsite point to which you know the coordinates. Please do watch the other videos to learn more about the individual methods, and thanks for watching.